Hello students, next we are going to look into the two formulations, that is the Newton formulation and the Lagrangian formulation. So first we will start with the Newton formulation. The Newton formulation, okay. We'll start with the Newton formulation. So it is basically in Newton formulation, what we have is we have the relations between the joint position, which can be either theta or x, that is the revolute joint, and for the case of prismatic joint. And its velocity, which is basically for the case of revolute, it will be theta dot, and for the case of prismatic, it will be x dot, which is the differentiation with respect to time, and the acceleration. Which is basically for the case of revolute, it will be theta double dot, which is double differentiation of theta with respect to time, and x double dot for the case of prismatic joint of the manipulator. Manipulator is also basically a robot. Okay, a robot is also called as a manipulator. So it's the relation between the joint position, velocity, acceleration of the manipulator and the force, we will name it as F, or the torque, which we will name it as tau, applied by the actuator and the external forces which cause motion, and the other external forces which cause motion. What is the other external forces? Basically gravitation. See, it's because of gravitation that you have to make the whole dynamic equation. So if you want to move an arm up, then basically you are moving against the, so if you have to move a link, suppose if you want to move a link in this direction, that means making it move up, then you are making or you are applying a torque which is opposing the gravitation. So it will be different than the torque that you would have to apply when you are moving in the same direction as gravitation, isn't it? So if you have to move an actuator up, you have to basically apply a torque, and if you have to move it down, you basically have to loosen up so that it automatically falls down, or if you want to make it fall down with a less acceleration than what is there in gravitation, then you have to obviously control it. So it just does not, you know, belong to, you know, how much, the velocity, joint position, everything. But it also depends on the gravitation. That's why it is written as the external forces which cause motion. So this I will, for the time being, leave it here. And we'll go to the next point. So what is the next point in Newton formulation or Newton Euler formulation is that we use the Newton's second law. So from Newton's second law, the force to move a mass mass, which we will name it as m, to accelerate, first is linearly, so to accelerate linearly, it is something different, and to angularly, it is different. Okay, for the case of linear, that means for the case of prismatic joint, the equation that we use is force is mass into acceleration, which is basically mass into the position double dot. Position double dot means differentiation of position with respect to time, double differentiation. Okay, so this is the force. And for the case of angular, which is basically revolute, we have what is called as the torque, and the torque is basically multiplication of the L, which is basically inertia multiplied with the angular acceleration alpha. So it is basically, what is angular acceleration? It is theta double dot. Okay, so it is basically the multiplication of the acceleration with inertia. Okay, and inertia, if you remember, for the case of torque, it will depend on how far away it is from the center. Okay, now anyway, we don't need to go too much deep into Newton formulation because we are not doing that. What we are doing is basically the Lagrange formulation. So what is the case of Lagrange formulation? What is the case of Lagrange formulation? Okay. The case of Lagrange formulation, it is based on kinetic energy and potential energy, and we basically do the differentiation. So it's based on the differentiation or with respect to the system variables and time. System variables and time. So it is differentiation with respect to system variables and time of what? Of the kinetic energy, which we will name it as K. And the potential energy. Which is basically represented as P. Okay. For that, we have to consider the joint variables or the joint positions, which I will name it as Q1, Q2, like that all the way up to Qn for n joint. So these are the joint positions, which we also call it as the position variables. And the differentiation of that, which is basically Q1 dot, Q2 dot, like that all the way up to Qn dot, which are basically the joint velocity, which are called as the velocity variables. Velocity variables. Okay, remember that out of this n, if you are taking any ith, you know, if you are taking any ith joint, that means if you are going to take any ith joint, then qi for a prismatic joint, for a prismatic joint, it will be x I, or even if it is in the y direction, it is yi, or even if it's in z direction, it will be zi. For revolute joint, it is going to be theta I. Okay. Then you can also write that qi dot for prismatic, for the prismatic joint, it will be xi dot or yi dot or zi dot based on the direction or the, you know, position. And similarly for revolute joint, it will be theta I dot. Okay. Now what we have to remember is that the position, the potential energy, or what we name it as P of a link, of ith link, is a function of not say the ith link, it can be any link. So I will name it as manipulator. Okay. Why? Because the ith link may also depend on the I minus 1 link or the I plus 1 link. So it is all interconnected. So I will just write manipulator. The potential energy P of the manipulator is a function of qi, and the kinetic energy, which is also named as K, capital K, of the manipulator is a function of qi dot. That means it is a function of velocity. So the potential energy is basically based on position, and the kinetic energy is basically based on velocity. That is what this says. And now comes the most important thing, that we define Lagrangian. So Lagrangian is defined as L is equal to the kinetic energy minus the potential energy. That is what is the capital L Lagrangian, and with this help of Lagrangian, we can find out the position and not position, the force and the torque required. So then from Lagrangian, which is basically capital L, we find the force or torque. So what is the case of force? Force is for the case of prismatic joint, and torque is for the case of revolute joint. Okay, we find the force and torque as the equation for the ith link, the force in the ith link, is given by the time differentiation d by dt of the differentiation of Lagrangian with respect to position xi minus, no, it is not differentiation, it is basically dou. It's not d, it is dou. So let me write it as dou minus dou l by dou xi. Similarly, tau I is basically a differentiation, that is the torque is basically d by dt of dou by dou theta I dot. So here I have forgotten to write xi dot. Let me rewrite that again. This is basically xi dot. Okay. So theta I dot minus dou by dou theta I of L. Okay. So this is something, this is the formula that we used for finding the force and torque. So using these two formulations, using these two formulas, we will try to define for any manipulator what will be the force and the torque required. So remember here, the position and the velocity is basically used with the Lagrangian. And what is the Lagrangian? Lagrangian is basically the difference between the kinetic energy and the potential energy to find out the force and the torque. We will see an example in the next video. Thank you.